will be held today at 2 p.m. at Bethany Baptist Church. Rick Dearman officiates, interment with military honors in Bethany Memorial Cemetery. Hansville Funeral Home is directing. Mr. Kilgo passed away on Friday. Funeral services for Talmage Filyaw, age 76 of Logan, will be at 2 p.m. today at Graveside, with the Reverend Steve Bryan officiating at Emmaus Cemetery in Logan. Moss Service is directing. Mr. Filyaw passed away on Friday. Funeral services for Dwight Faust, age 85, of Cullman, will be at 11 a.m. tomorrow at Moss Service Funeral Home Chapel. Interment will follow in the city cemetery. Moss Service directs. Mr. Faust passed away on Saturday. Visitation will be 6 to 9 p.m. this evening at the funeral home. And those are our obituaries for today, brought to you by Moss Service and Hansville Funeral Home.
Welcome to Today on 2. It is Monday, the 14th day of January. Did we say it might rain?
Yeah, I think so.
I think we did, and it did.
And I think it's going to continue for a little bit. They said today, doesn't it? Yeah, I woke up this morning thinking, I thought it was gone, but it's not yet, is it?
Nope.
Oh, well.
More rain. Let's check the weather. Brought to you by Mitch Smith Chevrolet and Cherokee Avenue. Make the switch to Mitch. Weather Almanac for the 14th of January. The average high temperature is 53. The average low is 27. The record high 76 in 1972. And the record low 4 degrees in 1962. Sunset this afternoon at 5 o'clock. Sunrise tomorrow morning 1 minute earlier than it has been at 6:52. We get a little bit more daylight now. There's the satellite picture with that slow movement of rain. Actually, that, what do they call it, an Arctic front or something that's really dipped way down into California and Texas, pushing the rain through our area. Here's the forecast for today. Once again, cloudy, breezy, 90% chance of rain, a high 37. Mm-hmm. Yesterday it was 70.
I know. I know. It's so strange.
For tonight, cloudy, breezy, 90% chance of rain again tonight, low of 33. More of the same tomorrow with a high of 42. Wednesday, just a 50% chance of rain, high of 49. And Thursday, chance of rain 47. Friday, sunshine returns with a high of 49. Saturday 51, so we get back to normal temperatures, but wow, interesting weather.
It really is.
At least no tornadoes.
I know. Thank goodness for that.
Oh, goodness. Did you have a good weekend?
I did. I got to go visit my grandson, Logan. Uh-huh. Of course, I have a picture, you know. I'm just a terrible grandmother. Want to share all these pictures with you. Remember the other day how I showed you he was sleeping upside down out of that hole? Well, now he's sleeping on the floor. You see him off to the left. That's him in front of the door. He got out of his bed and he crawled on the floor with his little Linus, his little blanket, and I just had to share that with you. You know, he does stay in the bed most of the time, but in the morning he'll get up and he'll try to get out and can't get the door open, so he sits there right in front of
Poor kid's trying to get out of the room and they've got him locked in.
<I know. laughs> Poor little baby.
Oh, goodness.
But anyway.
Well, let's see, who's our Facebook friend of the day?
And that would be Miss Berlina Davis. I hope I'm saying that right. And let me see a little bit about Berlina. She loves classic rock and country music. Well, very good.
That's an interesting mix,
isn't it? Yes, it is. But I kind of like that, too, classic rock and country music. So we're glad she's our friend. And if you want to be our friend, just like us on Facebook, Channel 2, spell out the number 2, Coleman.
We have some interesting guests today.
We really do. I'm all excited.
We love to talk to authors, and it's not very often that we get to talk to an author and the main characters in the book.
I know, main characters. I like that. We will get to talk to the main characters. Single-Handed is the name of the book, and it was written about Keith Mays and his little Jack Russell Terrier, Wishbone, which is an amazing dog. And they have a special story, of course. And Loretta Wade was the author, and she wrote the book. And so we're going to visit with all of them, even Wishbone's here. He is quite a character, too. I've heard a lot about Jack Russell Terriers, but this really gets into how tenacious they are. Is that a good word for them? They're tenacious?
Yeah.
Anyway.
So we will tell you the story of Single-Handed with all the people involved here in just a little bit. Coming up next, George Spear has news and commentary.
At Premier Bank, we are very proud of the long-lasting relationships we have with our customers. We'll go almost anywhere to meet your banking needs.
Overwhelmed by home refinancing offers from telephone solicitors and direct mail advertising, and then find you're not qualified for a specific plan? The Mortgage Center, a hometown lender, compares the rates from all home loan lenders and the qualifications of the various government programs to find a plan best suited to you. The Mortgage Center helps Cullman County people purchase and refinance their homes.
This is Pat Moody. Call us today and let us tailor a loan program to your specific needs and requirements.
Meet the KitchenAid 36-inch induction cooktop. It might just change the way you cook. Induction technology heats the pan and not the cooking surface to offer you a new level of precision, speed, and energy efficiency. 9 settings give you different levels of heat to achieve precise temperatures and amazing responsiveness. Water boils in just seconds, making this the fastest to boil induction cooktop available. The KitchenAid 36-inch induction cooktop.
Life lived in black and white is not a life lived. Today, I choose color. To see it. To feel it. To be in it. To be upon it. And to live a life surrounded by it. Today, I put on a fresh coat.
Time for news and commentary. If you've got something you'd like to share with us this morning, or share your opinion on some of these stories, you're welcome to give us a call. Don't forget we're streaming live at channel2cullman.com. We have some plans for a new school, Coleman High School, and I saw one of the drawings up in the newspaper this morning. If you've got that, you'll see plans for this, the new one over there. That's going to be a really good-looking building, apparently. I guess there's a meeting tonight. I'm not sure if it's a council meeting or if it's going to be the Coleman City School Board. I would assume they have to approve it first before they continue. It'll be a couple of years before they can get it all built, so that's great. Compared to what it would have been like about 180 years ago in Alabama, you know, when some of the first settlers came in. I had the benefit of coming across a newspaper article in Anniston, Alabama, and it had been written in the about 1912, and an ancestor of mine had been quoted. He was talking about his family coming to Benton County, is what they call it back then, Cleburne County now, right, and coming into the woods and all the sounds and threats that they had because of Native Americans, Indians had not been removed that many years before then. Now, some were still around. We talked about going to school and having to sit on on pine trees that had been cut in half, right, as a bench. He said sometimes your pants froze to the the rosin coming out of the pine tree, basically. But things were tougher then. You didn't have so many people saying we're entitled to this, entitled to that, right? You know. Anyway, good for Coleman High School. There is a senator from North Alabama. Actually, he's from Decatur, who's sponsoring a bill this next session, which is right around the corner, that would block the use of welfare benefits for frivolous items. And what are we talking about? When we start talking about having to raise taxes, people want to know, what are you doing to save what is out there, already been collecting, right? Well, state lawmakers say Alabama taxpayers are footing the bill for things like booze, strip clubs, trips to see psychics. There's abuse going on, and they're trying to get rid of some of it. The question is, how far will they be able to go, you know? If we have to deal with entitlement people think they're entitled to this and entitled to that, then how many of those people are going to start screaming, and how much of an effort will there be to go through with it? One thing I wished I'd asked Barry Willingham, the revenue commissioner for Coleman County, back last Friday in the That's Politics show. He was talking about how they are unable, as they had initially had said they would be able, when you come up to buy a tag for the new year, they can check to see if you've got liability insurance on a vehicle that you own. If they can't check, can a policeman or a state trooper or a deputy check? That's one of the things we'll have to try to find out. It's not going very smoothly, the process, but it'll be interesting to find out about that. And when you got way too much time on your hands, you do what some bozos seem to be doing when it comes to the president's website, We the People. People can write in if they get so many petitions signed, different ideas. You know, we had right after Obama won re-election, you had the situation where people wanted to secede from the union, you know. There were like 8 states, Alabama among them, okay, wanted to actually just pull the plug, get out. Well, now you got some bozo who wants to say that they want to make sure that nobody gets in the way of Brent's. What's the name of this guy, the one that did the commentary on McCarran's wife, or rather his girlfriend? We the People website's got a petition to get rid of McCarran, to deport McCarran so that his girlfriend has a chance with a sportscaster. Way too much time on your hands, okay? Oh, Circuit Judge Don Hardiman and Circuit Clerk Robert Bates, retiring, had an event for them, late last week. Judge Don Hardiman was elected in 1994, and I remember that well because I was on the radio at the time, and one of the things you like to do is create a stir, create an interest in an issue. So I'd have what they call the straw polls. People who will vote for this candidate, call in, and we'll write them off, see who's ahead. Well, I didn't even remember this particular race, but I did one for that race that Don Hardiman was in. And in 1996, when I began to run for chairman of the county commission, Don Hardiman's wife walked up to me and says, "You and that blasted straw poll, you had us behind so many percent." Of course, it was just a straw poll. It wasn't official or anything else. But that was kind of amusing. A lot of folks were tuning in. And it's always interesting when you talk about those kind of issues. Officials are trying to figure out, why is it that Alabama is one of the highest rated states when it comes to people committing suicide, you know? Yeah, I mean, it's higher than national average than people committing suicide. Trying to figure that out. Governor Robert Bentley is backing off an idea of trying to give incentives for state employees to retire early. He says we're finding that some of the cost-cutting measures are working. I think Bob Bentley's got one of the highest ratings, you know, when it comes to governors. Even though it's a bad economy and such, he still is very popular, and he seems to listen closely. I'm glad that we've got somebody like that as a governor who is doing that. All right, I think we've got a caller here, don't we? Is that what that means? Hey there. Hold on a second. Let's try it again. Hello? That means... Okay. Disregard. Disregard. Just checking. At any rate, Al Sharpton weighing in on the possibility of Barack Obama having a spot on Mount Rushmore. Someone wake me when this nightmare is over, okay? All right, that's all I got. More up today on 2 after this.
There's stuff around your house, but we don't make stuff. We make ovens. Dual fuel, double ovens. And they bake so evenly that now delicious is something you can depend on. We only make things for one room. The best room. Your kitchen. We're devoted to it. And you can feel it in everything we make. Nobody knows the kitchen like KitchenAid.
Overwhelmed by home refinancing offers from telephone solicitors and direct mail advertising, and then find you're not qualified for a specific plan? The Mortgage Center, a hometown lender, compares the rates from all home loan lenders and the qualifications of the various government programs to find a plan best suited to you. The Mortgage Center helps Cullman County people purchase and refinance their homes.
This is Pat Moody. Call us today and let us tailor a loan program to your specific needs and requirements.
Westminster Assisted Living.
It's like five-star hotel service.
There's a full-service beauty salon, barbershop, library, and activity rooms, private dining room for personal and family entertaining, and a skylit two-story atrium conversation area. Westminster Assisted Living also has a memory support care unit for residents with Alzheimer's and other forms of dementia. Westminster Assisted Living. Come live with us.
At Premier Bank, we take pride in serving our community. We respect our customers, and we've won awards for our ethical conduct. We're motivated to do all we can for you, and we're interested in your banking needs. We're efficient, safe, and sound, and our relationships with our customers are second to none.
At Premier Bank, we put the customer first.
Welcome back to Today on Two. It's time to give away our prizes for today. And I think we have something new. We've got some new prizes that have been coming on. Let's see what we have for today. We have the day pass to Hurricane Creek Park, the Buddy Rogers Natural Area. And we also have the bag of assorted apples from Steel Orchard. That's it.
That's
okay.
It. Okay.
All right. I was expecting Bojangles, but okay. We'll do Bojangles tomorrow or some other day. So we got the apples and the day pass to Hurricane Creek Park. Let's look at some of our merchant ads. Then we'll ask you a question about one of these ads. Who are we going to start with? Deb's Bookstore, your hometown bookstore just down the road. Browsers are welcome. Gift certificates always available at Deb's Bookstore.
And Mr. Hicks Menswear, this is Reader's Choice Award winner for men's clothing here in Cullman, now offering suits made to your measurements. And that's, of course, at Mr. Hicks Menswear right there on Compass Way.
Tires for Less is more than just tires. They do oil changes, minor engine repair, shocks and brakes replaced. Come and see Greg and the guys at Tires for Less.
And, of course, what does happy look like? Well, we've got a picture of it right there. It's the Allegria shoe, and that is can be found at Uniform Place right there at 300 2nd Avenue Southeast. All these different varieties that are available.
Tutor Doctor says make this the best school year ever. They authorize personal one-on-one tutoring in your home according to the hours that are best available for you.
And Earl's Body Shop reminds you to move over for those emergency vehicles as you're traveling down the road. They have large and small towing available, local or long distance, at Earl's Body Shop.
Yates Chance Christian Bookstore, a better way to shop for Christian entertainment, is the MyEbo Color Tablet. Download songs, ebooks, audiobooks, and Bibles, video games, all available at the Yates Chance Christian Bookstore.
People's Tires Break and Alignment Center has their daily special. Look, every day of the week they have something available, and you can save a little bit of money, so go by there on Catherine Street.
And Sorelli Jewelry is available at Doug Dogga Jewelers. This is antique-inspired heirloom jewelry. That's why you shop at Doug Dogga Jewelers on Compass Way. And there we go with our merchant ads. Some of the merchant ads we have for today. The question is, what is the blizzard of the month from Dairy Queen? Or maybe you could tell us what's in it, if you don't remember the exact name.
Right.
And the reason we're asking the question is we don't remember what it is.
No. We need a little.
You could say anything and win, couldn't you?
Yeah. We need a little reminding here.
What is the blizzard of the month, or the ingredients for the blizzard of the month for the month of January from Dairy Queen? 256-734-7399 is our telephone number. Our prize for today, the bag of assorted apples from Steel Orchard, and the day pass to Hurricane Creek Park.
Yeah.
And have you tried the blizzard for this month?
No, I have not.
You did December.
Well, my big deal is in October when they do the pumpkin.
Okay.
Yeah, that's my favorite.
Maybe
one.
Paige said that she tried.
Okay.
I don't know.
Yeah.
But tell us what's in it, if you don't remember the name of it. It's got one of your favorite flavors.
Most people.
For most people.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I do know a few people that do not actually like this particular flavor.
I'm not. I like it, but I don't crave it.
Really? Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I like it too, but there's, I don't know, I guess I don't crave it either.
Oh.
I don't know. Some women say that they crave that or...
That ought to give it away.
Times of the month, they really crave it.
Okay, we need to get a phone call here quickly and see. Okay, they tell us line two. Are we not talking to the camera people today?
His thing doesn't work at all.
Okay, hello, who's calling?
This is Tim from Carmen.
All right, what's the blizzard of the month at Dairy Queen?
It's chocolate candy shop.
That'll work. Chocolate candy? Yeah, it's Choco something. We
Choco
know that.
Blast, I think,
all right.
is what it is.
Stay on the line.
Got lots of chocolate in it, though.
Okay, thank you for calling in. Yes, it's chocolate and candy.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And maybe chocolate candy. I don't know. Let's check it out. Let's look at the rest of our ads. Starting with AmeriGas, America's propane company. They have new customer specials and tank sets. Installation, first-year tank rent is free. Special pricing on the first heating season if you're a new customer.
And Borden Family Pharmacy. Of course, the difference is not when you open the bottle, it's when you open their door. You can realize that they're a good neighbor pharmacy and they're just down the road from you right there on Highway 157.
Renard's Gallery and Gifts, an art gallery, a jewelry store, a gift store, custom framing is available. Renard's Gallery and Gifts on First Avenue Southeast.
And fitness opportunities await you at the Coleman Wellness and Aquatic Center. And of course, if you pay attention, we have those day passes for free occasionally, but you can go and try it out.
AutoTech, foreign and domestic auto repair and service. David Methman has moved his repair shop to County Road 1354 in Vinemont, between the Super Saver and Ridgemont Community Church.
There it is. It is the chocolate candy shop. He was right. And, of course, the mini blizzard meal deal would feature that in there if you wanted to. You can get all that for $5.
Hansfield Guns and Ammo, lower prices on guns, ammo, and reloading supplies. January special M&P 15, priced at $412.50, tax included.
And Knight Free Insurance Agency, providing insurance coverage for over three generations now. One of the top 10 growth agencies in the state of Alabama for auto insurance. And remember, got to have auto insurance if you're going to be driving.
Mullins Body Shop, over 50 years of auto body repair and towing. Call Sonny, Stacy, Beth, or Jim at Mullins Body Shop.
And Baldwin Counseling Center is available if you're having problems, you need to talk, you want some privacy. Weight loss is a great subject to approach during the month of January, and Dr. Howard Rogers can help you with that.
And let's check our birthdays for today. Who's celebrating a birthday on the 14th of January?
Looks like we have a few. Looks like Jack Clay has a birthday, Angela Eubanks, Linda Capel, I suppose, and Max Hassenbein. And so their names will be put into a drawing on Friday where they have the possibility of winning an 8x10 portrait from Baker Photography and an ice cream cake from Dairy Queen.
And coming up next, we'll tell you about the book Single-Handed. Stay tuned.
At Premier Bank, we're a bit old-fashioned. We actually answer the telephone when you call. However, old-fashioned doesn't mean we aren't up to date. With the latest technology, Premier Bank meets the various needs of our customers. Mobile smartphone banking, internet banking, ATMs, convenient offices. At Premier Bank, we have the right products right now with good old-fashioned customer service. At Premier Bank, we put the customer first.
20 years ago, it was a different breed of men who came west. They were looking for adventure and excitement. There was plenty of adventure to go around and lots of excitement. At first, it was the Indians who provided the adventure. And for those who lived to tell about it, there was no question about its being exciting.
is the cover of the book, Single-Handed. We are going to talk to the author, that is Loretta Wade, and we're going to talk to the main characters, Keith Mays and Wishbone. Welcome to the program today.
Thank you for having us.
Loretta, let me start with you. How did the idea of a book come about with this story?
Well, I had already published a couple of books, and then Wishbone's accident happened, and Keith was keeping his Facebook friends updated on his progress on Facebook, and I just thought that it would make a really good story. Everybody loves a dog story.
Sure.
And so I started talking to Keith about doing a book, and we worked together, and we thought we had the entire story when we started, but then we found out we didn't because some things happened as we were writing the story. But we're really happy with the outcome. It does have a happy ending, and that's what we wanted.
So, little Wishbone, tell us, Keith, of course, how did Wishbone get it? Single-handed now. He is missing his left front leg and paw and whatever, and so tell us a little bit about how that happened.
Wishbone was, he's a rowdy little dog. He stays out in the woods and tree squirrels and runs the goats, and he lives on the farm, and he's just a real active little dog. But we have coyotes, and coyotes, I think, we don't know for sure, but he's got a little mate too, Jessie, and she, the day I found him messed up, Wishbone, I couldn't find them anywhere, and in the book it tells how we were hunting for them, and they're always available, and I couldn't find him, and I went around, and finally I found them. They had got themselves in the dog pen itself, and I noticed Jessie laying outside the house, and she was eat up. She had a lot of lacerations on her, and I reached in to get Wishbone, and he bit me. So I had to get a coat hanger to drag him out of the house, but when I drug him out of the house, both limbs on the front were just broken at a high point. Mm-hmm. So at that point, I took him to the vet, and they tried to put him back together. But he, unfortunately, wound up like me, single-handed. He got an infection in one of the legs, and it had to be amputated to save his life.
Mm-hmm. Now, but it has slowed him down just a little, hasn't it?
A little bit, yeah. You know, people seem to have a tendency to feel sorry for someone who has a limb or a dysfunction, but it's really, if you read the book, it's really not all that bad.
Because this has happened to you too, hasn't
right,
it?
And right,
this was
so.
That's really, I think, your story. I mean, I know it's been about Wishbone, but really the book is about you and your trials and tribulations that you have faced through the years.
This is true. We're blessed. I keep telling myself, you know, every day, we're blessed. We don't look at ourselves as handicapped, me or Wishbone. We go on with what we have and try to make somebody else's life better. That's what this book's about. The book's about hope. Mm-hmm. I've got this famous saying that I always say, this book is better than Oh Yeller, We Live.
Yeah, and that is a good thing. I'll tell you that Dennis and I both had a chance to read the book, and I enjoyed it. And one of the things that hit me, I guess I'm all about the Second Amendment, you know, the right to bear arms, and in this book, there's a chapter that you, I guess, dedicate to the fact that you have a cousin that lives in Georgia, really kind of had lost communications with, not stayed in touch with a lot.
That's true.
And he decides that he wants to hand down his grandfather, your grandfather's, shotgun.
Correct. That was a great story.
It was phenomenal. And after I read the letter from him to you about how why he wanted to give this to you instead of his own son, I don't know, it made me feel like this is what it's all about. People don't get it. This is an heirloom in the family. This is something your dad, your grandfather used to hunt with, you know, to survive with, basically. And he's giving this to you. He's passing this down generation to generation. You have a son. You have a grandson. He knows it will continue to stay in the family.
That was one of the key parts about
Wishbone. I knew this was going to happen.
That was the key point to Wishbone and, well, it wasn't Wishbone, but it was me receiving the gun. I was the only Mays that had a son and a grandson that could be passed on. All the rest of the family had females. So we wound up getting the gun, and it was a big surprise. But Hugh Lee had cancer as well, and I think he was preparing to get rid of the things that, that's a bad statement, pass on things that were important to him.
And he wanted to make sure that the right person received
that's
it.
That's right.
When he does pass, he wants to know that,
And I kept the original letter that he wrote me, and I put it in the gun case, and it has to go with the gun.
Sure.
When I pass it on.
Right. And I think that it's just, I think that sometimes people miss that, the fact that, that these are things that get passed from generation to generation. It means a lot to you. There's a lot of history behind it. You've been hunting with your grandfather before while he was using that gun. So anyway, that was the highlight. And I know that sounds silly, but when I read that, I just had to stop and really think about that. You've done a great job of writing this book. Where can we get these books?
You can actually get one next door today. Deb's has got this book in her store. J&S Karaoke here in Huntsville's got copies of it. We've got them scattered just everywhere. There's books at Between Rainsville and Fife. It's Country Corner. We've got them at the Jet Pep across the road from the Arab's Stockyard. We've got them at Bob's Meat Market in Arab. We've got them at Pampered Pets. We've got them at Lifestyles Hair Saloon. We've got them at Hugh Laco Store. We did a book signing there. And New Harmony Merchandise, they've got them. And we're also on Amazon, and you can ebook, or you can buy there, or you can buy direct from us. But there's many ways to get the book, and we hope everybody in Coleman gets it. I'm Coleman County. It's an all-local store, all-local people that's in the book. All of it's true. Loretta kind of exaggerated on me a little bit.
Well, it's a great story, and we're so glad you could come to visit, and we're glad we got to meet Wishbone.
Yeah, he's kind of getting sleepy now.
Loretta, what's your next book?
Well, I am working on a book that I've titled Where the Willows Weep, but it's fiction, completely fiction.
Do you prefer writing fiction?
I do.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. And where are your other books available? Are they available
Amazon.
On Amazon?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Loretta Wade is the author. Thank you, Loretta.
Thank
and
you.
Keith
Thank
and
you.
Wishbone.
I've got to say, we're rated 5 stars as well, so Loretta's done well.
Okay. Yeah.
Popping off.
I do. It's Wishbone.
Okay.
I told you.
Okay.
We'll be back with more of Today on 2 right after this.
In the nation, we can't make every annoying thing disappear, but we can eliminate deductibles. Nationwide insurance members who add vanishing deductible get $100 off for every year of safe driving. Join the nation where deductibles go.
Nationwide is on your side.
At 5 o'clock on the morning of August 19th, 1934, the transcontinental train journey began, which was to be unique in history. Its destination was the new escape-proof prison on the island of Alcatraz. And its passengers were 54 case-hardened and desperate criminals, headed by the gangster overlord whose deeds had given him the undisputed title of Public Enemy Number One, Scarface Al Capone.
E-I-E-I-O.
And on the farm we have some turkeys.
E-I-E-I-O. Come
over
here, come over
there, and come here, come there, quack,
quack, quack, quack, quack,
quack,
quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack,
Community billboards are brought to you by Pepsi and Coleman Jefferson Gas. Robert Post is one funny guy, and he will be performing tomorrow night at the Wallace State Community College, right there in the Betty Leith Haynes Theater. And, of course, this is part of the Coleman Community Concert Series. If you don't have a ticket, you can buy one tomorrow night. Baxter Black appearing live at the Coleman Civic Center on Saturday, January the 19th. Coleman County Cattlemen's and Cattlewomen's Association annual meeting is where he will be, and the registration begins at 5. Steak dinner is served. Ticket prices included in the dues. For more information, contact Steve Lake at 256-734-4052. Coleman Animal Shelter needs your help. The shelter needs items such as leashes, kitty litter, large wire crates, harnesses of all sizes for small to medium to large, and housing pens. Please call 256-338-2936 to obtain additional information. And if you have a community billboard you want to share with us, you can email it to channel2coleman@gmail.com, fax it to 256-734-7680, or be a friend on Facebook, Channel 2 Coleman. Spell out the number 2.
Weather forecast brought to you by Mitch Smith Chevrolet on Cherokee Avenue. It's going to be rainy and breezy again today. 90% chance of rain with a high of 37. Cloudy and breezy tonight. Again, more rain, a low of 33. More of the same tomorrow with a high of 42. Tomorrow, who's our guest?
Robert Post, the comedian that's performing tomorrow night. He's going to be here to give us a little bit of his routine, possibly.
Yes,
sounds
he will.
Like one funny guy. So if you don't have tickets, no problem. You can go down there and purchase a ticket right there at the door.
Okay, that's our program for today. Thank you for watching Today on 2.
Hope you have a great day.